mega celebrity status, the life of luxury, the world at his fingertips, the original Joe billionaire, Solomon. He saw it all, had it all, and did it all. But this guy wasn't just rich. He was also considered the wisest man who ever lived. We're talking smarter than a fifth grader, like Jeopardy's Alex Trebek level of wisdom. However, he had a nagging question in the back of his brain. What's the meaning of it all? He was struggling with purpose. You're born, you go through infancy and childhood and adolescence, then you're an adult, then you're old, then you die. What's the point? Life's just a series of births and funerals with everything in between meaningless. There's no real progress. The Earth keeps going around the sun over and over again. It's meaningless. He kept acquiring more and more stuff. More riches, more status, more women. Meaningless. Nothing is new. It's just the same old, same old. People do the same thing day after day, year after year, generation after generation. They still work the same. They still struggle the same. They still sin the same. Still meaningless. So what did Solomon conclude from all of this? That there is no meaning to it all. But that was nagging him too. He asked himself, how can I be totally sure there's no meaning and happiness in life unless I search for it myself? So he dove into his search for significance. First, he studied more. And if it wasn't enough to be the straight-A student at the top of his class, he wanted the I'm a teenager with a PhD type of status. But he soon realized that having all the knowledge only meant he understood even more how meaningless life was. He decided it would be better to be stupid and happy, scratch wisdom, move on. So then he decided to try the path of partying. He found fellow fun seekers to join him. Bungee jumping, skydiving, cow tipping, mailbox smashing, or something like that. Each thrill was topped by the next one, but he discovered that it felt great, but had no substance. Still meaningless. Next. If just having fun wasn't the answer, perhaps he needed something that would give him belly-shaking and belly-aching kind of laughter. The type of laughs that make you snort. And laugh, he did. He laughed and laughed and laughed and realized his heart was still full of pain. Laughter couldn't forever hide the miseries of life. Still meaningless. Now what? Maybe numbing the pain was the answer. So he drank and passed out and drank some more. He was the original poster boy for AA, waking up each morning from a drunken binge with a massive hangover. But then he discovered that the depression came back, and it took more and more alcohol to get the same feeling. What's worse, the pain kept coming back when the buzz wore off. There's no painkiller for the soul. Meaningless. So he went the route of more stuff. He built massive gardens, ponds, and vineyards, all for himself. But still meaningless. So then on to image and status. Meaningless. Maybe things didn't work, but how about pure gold? Nope, cash wasn't the answer either. Meaningless. Next, sex. Live like a playboy. Definitely meaningless. Maybe power was the answer. He dove deep into his role as king. Still meaningless. Of course, in all these pursuits, money, possessions, popularity, sex, he did find a feeling of fulfillment, importance, and happiness. But it was all temporary. They're only cheap substitutes for the real thing. Solomon finally wised up and found the one pursuit he had overlooked, a spiritual pursuit. He quickly discovered that no amount of mental, physical, or emotional answers could plug the spiritual hole in his soul. Everything quickly fell into place in this new pursuit, and he realized it boiled down to three things. Enjoy life fully as a gift from God, take God seriously, and seek God early on in life. He discovered that money, possessions, power, fun, all of that was meaningless. Those things only became meaningful when God was put in the center of them. He finally got out of the meaningless rut by focusing on the Creator, rather than the created. And he was finally able to answer his original question. What's the meaning of it all? God. Period. That's it. He is the meaning.